This is Rifam, Beis Gadach, Lamed Zion. The Mishnah said, Lo Dunner, Lo Makachin, Lo Holtzin, Lo Miyavnin. You can't judge, you can't betroth, you can't perform chalitza, you can't do this elaborate marriage. And the Gemara comments, Chulam, Azir, Mishnah, Shem, Yechdov. The three left, you write. Lo Makachin, Lo Makdishin, Lo Ma'arichin, Lo Machrimin. You shouldn't consecrate. Make assessment vows, or declare a chirim, or it's being donated to the Beis HaMikdash. The name should not be called Namkar, because a decree was purchasing and selling. Ramadan Tumos of Masarot, and it's used as singular actually in our Mishnah, but they shouldn't set aside Tumos and Maishas. But feel a little bit on Baba Yom, even to give it to the Kohen on that day. Comment on that. Rani Milu, the Tila may ask, well, this is where they were tevel yesterday. Well, Perry the Tila hidden, but fruits or produce that was became tevel today could go on Yisrael if we say Nimena Chala. In order to separate Chala from it, Mafishin, even the Chafi. That you would separate and give it to a Chafi. Now the Rift digresses to Yerushalmi. Chum Chasu, well, Ben Anusim, Ben Chogin, Ben Mizidim, Ben Martin, and all of which they did, whether at family carelessly, deliberately, or whether they were misled, Masha Asulasli, that which they did was done. Rishabbos, this is true. Shabbos, Ben Tarachon, Yom Tov, and certainly on Yom Tov, which I mean, we do from here. Demanda Avar, if somebody violates Achne Bishabbos, Mikarzai, Yom Tovai, and getting their land, their movable objects, he acquires them. Zalaka is acquisition of acquisition. Now back to the costly, the one design number dollars. The Mishnah has concluded that there's no difference between Shabbos and Yom Tov except for Ochel Nefesh and needs it for eating. Or minimum, when we ask a question, because we have in the Mishnah, Hashim will pay with their Harub, but the Yom Tov will hold the Shabbos. You're afraid that the rain is gonna rain on your produce and on the roof, so you can lower them via skylight and Yom Tov, but not on Shabbos. This is not for the purpose of Ochel Nefesh. So I'm going to talk a little bit about Havei Sol Havei Shammai. It's actually a dispute between Bishol and Beit Shammai, and our Mishnah is Beit Shammai. It's not Beit Shammai, I'm going to make Motzin Lost, a Katan Vlas, a Lula Vlas, a Sefer Torah Lusha, so I'm going to be still not even. Beit Shammai has said he can't bring out a minor or a Lula for Sefer Torah, it's a public domain. Beit Sol permits this because Beit Sol said that once something is allowed for Ochel Nefesh is also allowed for other purposes. So this mission, as I said, Ein Ben Shabbos, Liyom Tzadol Ochol Nefesh, that was Beit Shammai. Now on to the next mission. Ein Avakelim Keragle HaBaldim. The animal and the vessels are like the legs of the owners. And that means that they have Tzum Shabbos, Tzum Yom Tov, so they can go as far as the owners can go. Moshe Ben Ma does know the Roeh. If somebody gives over his animal to his son or to his shepherd, Reel Kiraklav, these animals are like his legs. And our version of the mission actually says Kiragle Ha Baalim. It means basically the same thing. Maybe you could make some kind of argument that it doesn't, but let's say that it actually means the same thing. Kelan hamiyuchadim le'achad min ha'achim. Let's say you have two brothers, and they have somehow two different Tchum Shabbos. They're apart from each other, they set up different areas of Tchumim. But you have a vessel which is specific to one of those two brothers, Shevet Bayis, which is in the house. Harehin Kirab Lav. They are like the legs, like the Tchum of this one brother for whom this vessel was miyuchad for, which ain't miyuchadin. But if it's not designated for one specific brother, only to the place where they can all travel. Namely, if one has a Tchum Shabbos in one place and the other one has a Tchum Shabbos in another place, they're the place where they both could go, where there's overlap, that's where it could go. And we'll see that this is going to play out in the Gemara. The Gemara says, most of them told with no Leroah, the Chugai. If somebody gives over an animal to his son or to a shepherd, and it's strange because it says that the Tchum is like the Tchum of the owner as opposed to the Tchum of the shepherd. So, Kimna Bishneiro, and we're talking about where he gives it over to two shepherds, the Lokan Echa may have such that neither of two shepherds acquires it. And therefore, the Tchum of the animal is like the Tchum of his, the owner's, feet. because it's a single shepherd. It's like the tchum of the shepherd. And even if he only gave it over, handed it over on Yom Tov, it's still like the life of the of the shepherd. Now, Rabbanu, here's where it gets complicated. The sages lead in a brisa. It's two people borrowed a single cloak. One of them wanted to wear it in the morning to the study hall. And the other one to go at night to the synagogue. They are the level of only one of them made his tchum Shabbos. He established an Erev Tchumen to the north. The other one made an Erev to the south. And they're both standing next to each other as Shabbos or as Yom Tov comes in. But they established their Erev either to the north or to the south. The one who made it Erev to the north, Malach Utsafon, Kiragli Nishirol of their realm. He could go as far to the north with the cloak. It doesn't say this is supposed to leave, but that's what it means. He can go with this while wearing this cloak as far to the north as the one who made his Erev to the south. In other words, each of these Erevs puts a sets up the Shabbos residence at the place of the Erev. So if you make it to the south, so you don't have Tchum Shabbos 2000 Amos from the place where the person is standing, but rather to the south. The one who goes made it Erev to the south can't go 2000 Amos from the the south, but can only go to the south while wearing the cloak as much as the one who made his Erev to the north. Because, as we said before, we're talking about the intersection of the two areas of Tchum. Then Mitzvah love as a Tchum, and if they divide the Tchum exactly between them, each one takes his portion, there is no intersection between those Tchum. He cannot move the cloak from its place. And now the Rishon is going to say what I just said, but a little bit more verbose. Pirish is an explanation for this. Adam Shabbos the Makam. Somebody makes the Shvi'is of Shabbos, he establishes the Shabbos or Yom Tov residence in a specific place. Yeshua Chaim Amalachovach. He has 2,000 cubits in each direction. Then the Makam is here of Sokol Chaim Amalachovach. And let's say he puts his Erev 2,000 cubits away from him to the east. Yeshua Aloch Ad Makam Erevel. Makam Erevel, he could go up to his Erev of those 2,000 cubits, and he could go from that Erev, the Mizrach Alpaim, an additional 2,000 cubits, because his Erev is considered now his Makam Shvisa for Shabbos and Yom Tov. The Hain Alpaim Shahidu Lopamarav, and those 2,000 cubits which he would have otherwise had to the west. If Shemakam Erev also Alpaim Al Mizrach, and he puts his Erev, these 2,000 cubits, to the east, and I think Alpaim Al Mashahidu Lopamarav, we take away and move those 2,000 cubits which he had to the west, the Ruach HaMizrach, over to the eastern direction. Then after Lahalech, the Ruach HaMarav, to the Amachas, and he can't go from his present position even a single cubit to the west. And if he put his Erev 2,000 cubits to the east, he Makom Shvi'is himself from the place where he is when Shabbos comes in, or Yom Tov comes in. And then so Shadik Elif Amal Mizrach, if he puts it not 2,000 cubits, but he puts 1,000 cubits to the east from his Makom Shvisa. He basically borrowed 1,000 cubits from the ones that he has on the west, and he brings it over to the east. So he has 1,000 cubits left in the west. And thus he could go to the east 3,000 cubits. So the Ruach HaMarav Al Haman, he could go to the and he could go to the west 1,000 cubits. So that's basically it's the reason for all of this is he's instead of his Makom Shvisa, the place that he is when Yom Tov comes in, instead the central point of there is the point of the Erev. Now let's go analyze this. If two people borrowed a single cloak, One of them to go to the study of all the Ruach Midrash to the east. And the other one to go to the in the evening to the synagogue to the west. Oh, now we're going to talk to, we're going to translate it into the terminology of the Brisa that we cited, which is Tzafon and Daron, north and south. Let's go Shahaya, Beis HaMidrash B'Tzafon. Let's say the study hall was in the north, the Beis HaKnesses B'Daron, and the synagogue was in the south. Enough on Achad to Tzarech Leil Tzafon, S.A. Ruvel, B'Sof Elef Amah B'Tzafon. The one that wants to go to the north, because that's where the Beis HaMidrash is. So he puts his Eruv 1,000 cubits to the north. So he has 1,000 cubits to the north, and now he could go 3,000 cubits to the north. He could only go those 1,000 cubits to the south. This cloak is restricted only to the tum that is of the one who made it there to the north. Also the one to the south, but also the one to the north. So since it's restricted to the area where the guy who made it there to the north set his erev up, so Akal thinks of Haberal. Now, talking about his fellow, his friend who erev the Sof Elefam al Adaram, his fellow made his erev 1,000 cubits to the south. So that fellow, if he didn't have the cloak, the Darom Shloshes Alafim Amah, he could go 2,000 cubits to the south, in general. So 1,000 cubits he could go to the north and 2,000 to the south. Ein lo Rishus Alach B'Zeh Halach, the Darom Elar Alafim Amah. He can only go together with his cloak 1,000 amos to the south, because that's as far as the guy who made it there to the north could go, and so it's restricted by the restrictions of the fellow who made his heir to the north. So now, while holding the cloak, he can only go at Olafam Abulvad. Shu Karagli Mishir Volavu Sefon, which is equivalent to the tum of the one who made his heir to the north. The Chim Zeshir Volavu Sefon is similar to the person who made his heir to the north. Kevin Shechavro Erevul Yerom, since his friend made his heir to the south, the Sof Olafam at 1,000 cubits to the south, and so his friend who made it there himself can only go 1,000 cubits to the north, Bovad. Even though the one who made it there to the north, can, without the cloak, he could go 3,000 cubits to the north. He can only go 1,000 cubits to the north while wearing the cloak. Which is equivalent to the tum and the restrictions of the tum of the person who made his heir to the south. And this is the explanation of what we said, the person who made his heir to the north, he can only go to the north while wearing the cloak as much as the person who made his heir to the south. And the person who made his heir to the south, Mahalasul Daram, can go wearing the cloak in the south, directly to the throne, as much as the person who made his heir to the north. So, in other words, it's the intersection of the two tchumim. And now, continuing to give a parish of this. Then mitzvah of a tchum, and if they divide the tchum between them, such as no overlap, he cannot remove the cloak from Klomer, that's to say, if each one of them put their Erev 2,000 cubits away, one to the north, one to the south, he can't go while wearing this cloak, even a single cubit to the south. And the one that made it there to the south can't go to the north, even a single cubit while wearing this cloak. And since the cloak acquired residence, Shabbat residence, like the tchum of both of them, the intersection of both of them, you cannot move it from its place. Itmar, it was stated by Amorai. Shnayim Shalbachu Chavisu Heim Abishisbis. If two people acquired a calf or an animal in partnership, And it's a problem because they don't necessarily have overlapping plumb, and so they couldn't take from the other. So there might be a problem with the other. Some of the Pharisees the name of Shiva. Rav says that the cast of wine is permitted and the animal is forbidden. Shmuel Amar Hilu Chavis Asura. Shmuel says even the cast is prohibited. Rav Amar Chavis Mataras Kasavar Yesh Breira. Rav holds that it's permitted, the cast is permitted because he holds there's Breira. Breira is that what he eventually will take for himself, one of these partners. That takes effect now before Shabbos or before Yom Tov comes in. So as a result, his portion was coming to Shvisa in the specific place to the exclusion of the portion of the other fellow. Lehe Masura, and the animal is forbidden because the Kayanki Tsumin Mehadati, because each chum suckles from the other, it draws sustenance from the other. Kalomar, that's to say, Kayanki Behema. Yonkin Evrezamizah, since the behema, its limbs draw sustenance one from the other. And then the Tchumen Shabbat, Kilohim Murabin. The Tchumen of them are as if they're mixed, they're bizah. Well, it's Chayin and Vera, and therefore Vera can't possibly apply to them. Shmuel Amar Kilohab Sasura. And Shmuel holds that even a cask is forbidden. It's not Ranger, but it even holds that there's no Vera at all. That reminds me of it. We say what became of this issue. Rabbi Yochanan Amarin Breira, and Rabbi Hoshea Amar Yesh Breira. So this is my focus with Rabbi Hoshea being the one that says that it's Breira. Second is Rabbi Hoshea, Kiyas Lebera. When Rabbi Hoshea says that there is this Breira, but Rabbanan is only by rabbinic things, and Rabbi Hoshea Le'alais Lebera. He doesn't hold that there's Breira by biblical things. This is an office of the head of Rabbi Hoshea, and we talk to this with Rabbi Hoshea. It's not Rabbi Rabbanan Yesh Breira. That by rabbinic dinim there is Bera. Become like Rav Rav Hoshea v'chadash yitisa. And Rav Rav Hoshea hold one opinion, Shmuel Rabbi Yochanan v'chadash yitisa, and Shmuel Rabbi Yochanan hold also a single different opinion. Then the Kaya Rabbi Hoshea v'chadash yitisa v'chadash yitisa. And since we hold like Rav Hoshea and he's like Rav, I mean, the Hilchasa stuff is Rav. The old Allah is like Rav, which means that a cask of Shushin is permitted and a meanwhile, a Behemoth would not be.